What is a hero? Something to marinate on. But for now, let's mind our biscuits. Let's get our biscuits started. You've seen me make them before. You're not going to see me make them today, but just know it's going to happen. Yes, indeed. It's June the 8th. 2 days ago was the 80th anniversary of D-Day. That's something to think about. Also, this week, the kids got out of school. They're going to start their summer. That's also something to think about. My grandmother also passed away this week, and I couldn't get back home for it. But that's okay. Speaking of kids and summer, my grandmother would make mac and cheese, and she'd make biscuits, get that starch. I love it. And we'd have beanie weenies. And in honor of her, and in honor of that festive meal, I'm gonna be making pork chop mac tonight. There's nothing quite like being a kid in the summer. And especially if you have a good grandma. Let's get started. We're heating our water. Obvious, Captain Obvious. Bringing it to a boil, we're gonna do our pasta in it. And then we're heating our 13-inch Frisian. Yeah, you can see that. And that's where we're going to begin our onions. Frisian is at medium heat. It's warm. You can probably see the smoke. I'm gonna do 1 to 2 tablespoons of veggie oil because olive oil, too fancy. Too fancy. We doing veggie oil. Let's saute our one large yellow onion. We're going to do this for about 4 to 5 minutes. I'll tell you what, in the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and add our cavatappi pasta, 16 ounces, to our water that's near in a bowl, near in a bowl. While we're sauteing our onions, let's get our pork chops going. I've got roughly 3 pounds here, 4 chops, bone in. We'll do a little bit of salt and pepper on each side. Our onions are brown and glossy. Our onions are brown and glossy, people.
We gotta remove them now. So let's do that.
Here comes my favorite part. You know me. I'm the sear boy. And I'm about to sear some pork chops. Once again. 1-2 tablespoons veggie oil. We brought it up. It's a medium high. See if I can still handle it. Yeah, I can still handle it. Look at me. And my smoke alarm is probably about to go off here in a bit, but hey, enjoy it. I know the neighbors will. We're gonna do these about 3 minutes per side, and then we're going to remove. In the meantime, our pasta has finished for the moment. Let's drain it. Let's flip. Nice. Looking good. Okay, I'm thinking it's time to remove. Hey, you're crooked. Let's get you a little straight. Get you on the straight and narrow. There it goes. As I promised. Yeah, that looks good. Let me get this off you and let me tend to that alarm. Actually, you are not straight and narrow. You are still crooked. These may look a little different, but never you mind that. Never you mind that. Ah, swagger. We're gonna add 5 tablespoons of unsalted butter to our Frisian that is now reduced to medium heat. Remember, my Frisian is the 13-inch skillet that, when you mean serious business, it's gonna get it done. Let's let that melt. Oh, doesn't that look pretty? It's getting hot now. It's getting hot, but my hands still, well, handling it. This is gonna be kind of like our roux. Wow, I made a mess. About to make more of a mess. We got our butter, and now we're gonna do 5 tablespoons of flour. And we're gonna whisk the whirl out of this. For about a minute. Same principle with our roux. It's gonna help thicken things up. And we're gonna add milk. Let there be milk. 5 cups whole milk. Minced rosemary and sage. 2 tablespoons each. I'm also going to do a little bit of basil, just a little bit. Well, actually, yes. I feel I should apologize to everyone.
Likewise, a little bit of garlic salt. And a little bit of pepper. Fresh ground pepper. Good stuff. And we'll stir. And we're gonna turn the temperature up to medium high again and bring it to a boil. And I tell you what, while I got that on my mind, we're also going to preheat our oven to 375. So let's do that too. Doesn't that look pretty?
That's just pretty, I tell you.
We gotta keep whisking around though until it thickens. We'll do this for a few minutes. And bring it to a boil. So we brought it to a boil. It's thickened. Let's turn off our heat. Remove it. We'll continue to stir it for a bit. And then we're gonna do some magical things with it. Let's add whole thing of, well, whole milk mozzarella. Do the whole thing. Whole thing. What is this thing? And I would be remiss if I did not at least add some cheddar. We'll stir this a bit. We'll let it melt. Hey, that's something. Just letting cheese melt in a milk roux thing you've created. That's good stuff. Seriously, it's good stuff. Cheese has melted. It is time. And the oven is preheated to 375. Our pasta. Some great tomatoes. Now that that's over. We got our pasta and tomatoes stirred together. Let's add our chops. I bet you forgot about these, our onions. Just put over the top. Put some in the mat. Panko. Grated Parmesan. This is our last touch before a bake. Doesn't that just look delightful? We're going in. We're going in. 20 to 30 minutes. Let's see.
To the point of my original question, what is a hero? You may have a different idea, but I think a hero is one who does the extraordinary and exceeds the common relative to their environment. Also think a hero is one who peers into hell, frankly, but comes back with a little slice of heaven, even if for just a brief moment. Remember, it's D-Day anniversary 2 days ago. But it's okay to be common. I'm common. It's okay to be common if you create a family, nourish it, provide it with love and nurture, and see it through. You've done your duty. You have done your duty. We appreciate all who have done our duty. Grandma too.
Listen. Are we ready? I think we're ready. I'm going to remove.
This is a workout. This is heavy. Wow, look at that. Ain't that something? Let's add just a little bit of rosemary. Just you look at this meal we have here. Our pork chop mac, of course. One's gone missing. We'll figure that out later. We got baked beans with maple syrup and brown sugar. I did not make that. Coleslaw with raisins and almonds. I semi-made that. My biscuits, I did make. Remember, we started with that. And of course, our beanie weenies. Of all the things I could start with, I want to explain this in just a bit. Let's start with the beanie weenies. Just doing it raw, right out of the can. You know, I probably haven't had Beanie Weenies since those summer days back with Grandma. So, we made pork chops, and I made biscuits. I also made a pork chop biscuit, and I put it here on the table because I ran out of plates.
Man. That is good. That is very good. Let me just get one cut. If my table, my little table, and my knife will cooperate with me. Ooh, this is gonna be a big one. I got some of that mac. Wouldn't you love to be me right now? Y'all, it's so good. It's so good. My goodness me. Get some of that baked bean slaw. Goodness. Goodness. Before we close out, I want to share a meditation that I've done in the past week. Cool. So good. Stop shaking. Jeez. I call it On Endings. I'll read it to you. It's brief. And then we'll close out. I wish I could weave for you together a story. One that makes whole. Completes. A moment that never ends. Perfect. Captured in time, content. But the end is the thing. It's never whole. It's never complete. Endings are like that. Ceaseless we stir, unending we season. Nigh is always the time. No better time than I can think of. To tend our skillets and mind our seasonings. If existence is a sphere, as I imagine, we'll hold our kitchen's holy grace. Someone will be stirring out there in all that cold. All that dark. I'm Tyler. It's Wine Country Cast Iron. Always weird. Always good. Y'all take care.